Hello friends, welcome to my channel. If you like my videos, please subscribe and share to your friends. So today we are going to discuss another four adjustments in final accounts. So in the beginning class we discussed the four adjustments, which are outstanding expense, prepaid expense, accrued income, advance received income. And later we discuss depreciation, interest on capital, interest on drawings and set off. But today we are going to discuss 9 to 12 adjustments, which means four adjustments we are going to discuss today. So final accounts adjustments, we are going to discuss four adjustments. I will write here adjustment entry, and whenever it is given as a part of adjustments and what is the treatment, when it is given as a part of trial balance and what is the treatment. So effect in trading P&L and of course effect in balance sheet we are going to discuss today. And the first important adjustment we are going to discuss, that is the ninth one. Okay, so that is what, closing stock. Closing stock. So what do you mean by a closing stock? Generally every business at the end of the year, so when it would like to know the profit loss of the business, and there will be certain unsold stock, so which we call closing stock, left at the end of the period. The closing stock which is left at the end of the period, obviously it is a asset to the business, so closing stock to be debited. Whenever it is given as a part of adjustments, closing stock, the entry will be closing stock should be debited because it is asset, and again it should be credited to trading account according to matching concept. Okay, I will tell you entry like this: closing stock account debtor to, closing stock account debtor to trading account. So let us come to know once again, closing stock means at the end of the year when you would like to know the result of your business by final accounts, trading P&L, balance sheet. So there will be certain unsold goods with you, which is called closing stock. And of course closing stock to be valued in a proper way. And for that we have to write the adjustment entry. So that entry here is closing stock to trading account. And why closing stock is debit? Because it is asset, so debit. And why it is credited to trading account? According to matching concept, it is to credited to trading account. What does it mean, matching concept? Matching concept will tell you that when a particular revenue generated, so when a particular revenue generated, the related cost only to be matched. So to see the profit loss, to correct, to know the profit loss of your business. So when revenue generated, the related cost only to be matched. But this closing stock is there as a part of your purchases, which is there like a cost, but it is not generated any revenue because not it sold. So therefore it is to be eliminated to know the correct profit. So that closing stock which is there, of course, which is as a part of your purchases and as a cost, it should be eliminated to know the profit loss of your business, so that it is to be credited. I will tell you a small example. For example, this is a trading account and you bought 100 rupees goods debit side. Out of this 100 rupees goods, 50 rupees goods sold at 100 rupees, sales written this side. If you notice that out of this purchases, 50 rupees goods still unsold, means this 50 rupees goods not generated any revenue. When this 50 rupees not generated any revenue, and it should not be the part of cost, and this closing stock to be eliminated, you have to credit. Observe that then only the real profit of 50 rupees will come. So if you, the purchases, in purchases 50 rupees is there, and which is unsold stock, which is not generated revenue, if you do not eliminate that, and what happens, your profit will be zero. So that whenever the closing stock is eliminated, removed, so by writing credit side, then only profit will come out. That is what the matching concept. So how can you say whenever closing stock is given as a part of adjustments, and how do we explain about the closing stock entry? Closing stock is asset, therefore debit, and according to matching concept, it is to be credited to the trading account. That is the whenever it is given as a part of adjustments regarding closing stock, that is the entry, and we should work out closing stock to trading account. So whenever it is given as a part of, so it is given as a part of adjustments, it is not trial balance, it is given in adjustments. Okay, next, whenever it is given as a part of trial balance, whenever it is given as a part of adjustments, okay, this entry is to be simply incorporated into your final accounts. So when closing stock is given as a part of adjustments, this entry to be incorporated into final accounts means you can credit to trading account according to matching concept. Second time it is to be shown like a current asset in the balance sheet, right? Treatment is, it is to be credited to trading account. Second time it is to be shown as a current asset in balance sheet. So whenever closing stock is given as a part of adjustments, entry closing stock to trading account. Closing stock is a current asset, so debit according to matching concept, it is to be credited to trading account, and the adjustment treatment is, and it is credited to trading account, and also it is a current asset in the balance sheet. Sometimes closing stock, it is given in trial balance. Closing stock is given in trial balance debit side. Then what does it mean? When closing stock is given as a part of trial balance, then not just one entry, two entries were already written by you. You may write here the following two entries were already recorded. The following two entries were already recorded. So whenever closing stock given in trial balance debit side, so which indicates that two entries already written by you, which two entries were already written by you? Of course, you may have opening stock. Last year closing stock is the opening stock of this year. And there is some closing stock also at the end of the year. And both opening closing stocks are generated only from purchases, purchase of goods. So instead of writing in trading account, opening stock, of course, debit trading, closing stock credit, you can adjust the same to purchases. Okay, opening closing stocks can be adjusted to the purchases itself. But generally it may be done whenever closing stock is ascertained before closing the ledger accounts. If closing stock is known to you, then opening closing both you can adjust to your purchases. So normally if you write to trading account data to opening stock, instead of debiting to trading account, you can add to the purchases account. One entry written by you, purchases account data to opening stock account. Purchases account data to opening stock account. So your opening stock is added to your purchases. As and when this entry is recorded, if you check your trial balance, the opening stock is totally disappeared. Need not to debit to the trading account because already adjusted to your purchases. Second entry also written by you because closing stock also you ascertained before the ledger accounts closing. Then instead of closing stock account data to trading account, according to matching concept, it is to be credited to trading account. Instead of that, you can credit to the purchases account. Automatically purchase cost will be reduced. So that you may write the entry like this: closing stock account data to purchases account. These two entries already written by you during the year. So, but of course it is generally possible when the closing stock is ascertained before closing the ledger accounts. When closing stock is ascertained and closing stock you are having with you, then do one thing: opening and closing stocks, instead of writing trading account, better you can adjust to the purchases account itself. So opening stock is always added to your purchases. So Instead of trading account data to purchases, you can write purchases to opening stock. When you write purchases to opening stock, that is being already added to your purchases. So opening stock is totally disappeared in trial balance. It won't be there in your trial balance opening stock. Next entry written by you, closing stock to purchases. No doubt closing stock is asset according to matching concept to be credited to trading account, but instead of that I credited to purchases account. Automatically purchase cost reduced, so that closing stock is there in your trial balance debit side. Opening stock is totally disappeared, closing stock in trial balance debit side. Then closing stock which is given in trial balance debit side to be shown as a current asset in the balance sheet. Closing stock given in trial balance debit side to be shown as a current asset in the balance sheet. So need not to credit to trading account because already reduced from purchases. Purchase cost is already reduced. So that nothing to do here. You can come back to this place. Closing stock given in trial balance debit side to be shown as a current asset in balance sheet. Clear? So no doubt, which is very very important, closing stock generally at the end of the period, while ascertaining the results of your business, while knowing the results of your business, there will be some unsold stock and which is not yet sold by you, and of course it should be valued properly, and also there are correct entry to be recorded for this. Whenever closing stock is given as a part of adjustments, this is the entry you have to write, closing stock to trading account. How do you explain that entry? Closing stock is debit because if it is a current asset, and also why it is credited to trading account. According to matching concept, it should be credited to trading account. How do you explain matching concept? Whenever a revenue generated, how much cost incurred to relate the revenue that is to be matched, then only profit will come out. But the closing stock means which is there as a part of cost of purchases, but it is not generated revenue, so that it should not be there, it is to be eliminated, so you have to credit that. So this is the end. Simply it is a credited to trading account and current asset also when it is given as a part of adjustments. But whenever it is a given, closing stock may be given in trial balance debit side sometimes, then so many important things we should work out. And then whenever closing stock given as a part of trial balance debit side, only current asset, need not to credit to trading account. And moreover, should be very clear about certain important points. Closing stock is given trial balance means not just one entry, two entries are written by you. And moreover, when closing stock entry can be written by you, when closing stock is already ascertained before closing your ledger accounts, and then you may write the entry for closing stock. Not only closing stock, you can adjust your opening stock also. Both we can adjust to the purchases instead of, because both are generated from the purchases only, closing as well as opening. Instead of writing to trading debit and credit, you can adjust to the purchases. So normally what we used to write trading account data to purchases, trading account data to opening stock account. Instead of that, write one thing, purchase account data to opening stock and closing stock account data to purchases. So when you write these two entries, then your purchase is known as a adjusted purchases. If you find trial balance, it should be like adjusted purchases. Whenever it is like adjusted purchases, it is very clear opening closing stocks are adjusted to the purchases. And whenever it is given in adjusted purchases, opening stock will be totally disappeared. And moreover, closing stock is the part of trial balance debit side, and also it is like a current asset in the balance sheet. So which is very very important, closing stock adjustment and how to treat this. Okay. Next one, let us see, goods withdrawn for personal use. 10th one, I will explain the 10th one, see 10th one. Goods withdrawn for personal use. Goods withdrawn for personal use. So we know very well whenever goods are withdrawn for personal use, so which is simply known like a owner is the he is taking away goods and owner should be receiver and he should be debited. But we never debit him and we can use a representative personal account, that is a drawings. Drawings account debtor. And moreover, goods are taken over means goods to be reduced. Obviously, we can reduce the purchases to purchases. Whenever it is given as a part of adjustments, goods withdrawn for personal use, entry is drawings to purchases account. And accounting treatment, it is to be deducted from purchases in trading account. It is to be deducted from purchases in trading account. Second time, it is to be added to drawings in balance sheet, or it is to be deducted from capital. It is to be deducted from capital. Anything will be same, because so whether it is you can add to drawings or you can minus from capital, because total drawings always to be deducted from capital. So okay, so whenever it is given as a part of adjustments, when goods withdrawn for personal use, you can work out in that way. So whenever goods withdrawn for personal use given in trial balance, which means the above entry was already written. The above entry was already written. Which entry was already written by you? Drawings to purchases. Posting is also already done. In the drawings account to purchases, in the purchase account by drawings. Purchase account by drawings means purchase already reduced, need not to reduce. Already drawings account being added. Okay, so drawings ultimately you will reduce from your capital. So need not to do anything specifically. Whatever the work to be done, and both the works are already executed. Drawings being added, purchase has already reduced. So you need not to do anything and the required work is already done. Okay, this is what goods withdrawn for personal use. Okay, next one, let us see the 11th one, free samples. 11th one, free samples. Free samples means what? Generally every business, so as a technique of marketing technique, it can give certain goods like a free samples. It is nothing but like advertisements. So whenever free goods, some goods are given like a free samples. Free samples is undoubtedly expenditure to business debit side, because goods are given, so purchase to be reduced means to be credited. Therefore entry will be like this: free samples account debtor to, free samples account debtor to purchases account. Purchases account, whenever it is given as a part of adjustment, certain goods given like a free samples, this is the entry you have to incorporate. This is, it is to be deducted from purchases. It is to be deducted from purchases. Purchases. Second time, it is to be added to free samples in P&L. It is to be added. It is to be added to free samples. To free samples in profit and loss account. Okay, no effect in the balance sheet about it. Again, free samples is may be given as a part of adjustment. Sorry, as a part of trial balance. And what does it mean? The above entry was already written, posting is also already done. Which entry was written? Free samples to purchases. In the free samples to purchases, free samples already being added. In the purchases by free samples, purchase already reduced. And whatever the work to be done, that work is completed. Purchase is already reduced, free samples being already added. So need not to do anything. Whenever it is given as a part of trial balance, both works are already executed. That is what about the free samples. Next one is the goods used as stationery. Goods used as stationery. Generally, whenever we purchase the stationery outside, stationery to cash. But whenever we use goods as a stationery, stationery is no doubt expenditure debit. You can reduce your purchases. Therefore, entry will be like this. Stationery account HR2, purchases account. Stationery account HR2, purchases account. That is the entry you have to incorporate. Whenever it is given as a part of adjustments, goods used as a stationery, that is the entry you have to incorporate into your final accounts, so that it is to be reduced or it is to be deducted from purchases in trading account. It is to be deducted from purchases in trading account. Second time, it is to be added. It is to be added to stationery in profit and loss account. Okay, no effect in the balance sheet. Again, whenever it is given in trial balance, which means that above entry was already recorded and posting is also already done. Which entry? Stationery to purchases. In the stationery to purchases, stationery being added. In the purchases, by stationery, purchase being reduced. So you need not to do anything extra work. That work which is to be done, already done. Both the works are already being executed. So need not to do anything whenever it is given like a trial balance item. Okay, today we discussed only simply four adjustments. Very important adjustment out of these four is undoubtedly closing stock. And after that closing stock, we discussed so very clearly about the goods withdrawn for personal use, free samples and goods used as a stationery. Right now totally we discussed 12 adjustments. We can discuss some other adjustments in the next class. Okay. If you like my videos, please subscribe and share to your friends, and definitely will be useful to all your friends. All the best.